The midterm budget review is a revisit of the main national budget that was tabled in March this year. This time, the Treasury decreases and increases certain amounts that were earlier allocated to various sectors and ministries depending on the current need. The proposed reallocations will address under-budgeting on personnel expenditure, utilities, and other spending items, and also to meet resource shortfalls at Health and Social Services Ministry as a result of the third wave of COVID-19. The Ministry of Education, Arts and Culture has been allocated $400 million to cater for under-budgeting on personnel-related expenditure. Health and Social Services has been given an additional $400 million to boost the COVID-19 response plan. The Ministry of Gender Equality, Poverty Eradication and Social Welfare is allocated an injection of $15.3 million to support the rollout of social grants. The Public Enterprises Ministry took a share of $220.4 million to support the operations of public enterprises, including the leasing of locomotives by Transnamib, settlement of debt for AgriBizDev, and operational support to Namibia Wildlife Results, among others. The Ministry of Information, Communication and Technology has been given $141.7 million for the operations of the NBC. Agriculture, Water and Land Reform is allocated a total of $7.6 million for utilities and for AgriBank loan scheme. The Ministry of Finance will be allocated an additional $230 million consisting of $200 million for CIMA's funding shortfalls due to increased claims emanating from the third wave of COVID-19, and $30 million for subscription fees. For the current financial year, government revenue is estimated to rise to a tune of $1.5 billion. This is in consideration of the $408.6 million raised from fish quota auctions and $400 million from additional dividends declared by the MPTH, among others.
This revenue forecast did not include, I want to repeat, this revenue forecast did not include the potential proceeds from the listing of MTC, which will only be accounted once the Namibia Post and Telecommunication Holding, MPTH, has formally made the dividend declarations. You don't count your chickens before the eggs are hatched.
From an industry perspective, all major sectors are expected to record growth in 2022, although some will be moderate in comparison to 2021.
On the demand side, the projected growth in the domestic economy is projected to be anchored on the following: steady improvement in consumer demand, both domestically and globally, as economic activity normalizes. Improved momentum in exports, driven by upbeat production levels and complemented by projected gradual recovery in commodity prices, and reinvigoration in investments, both by the private and public sectors.
The budget deficit will remain unchanged at 8.6% of GDP, as was in the main budget, leaving the net borrowing requirements high, which the minister describes as a concern in the medium term. The debate on the reallocations has been postponed to next week, Tuesday, to give MPs time to study the bill. Timo Andreas, NBC News, Parliament.